टेक केयर, स्टे सेफ, स्टे एट होम, अल्लाह हाफिज।
Assalamualaikum students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and enjoying good health. So students, it's our fourth week. I'll start my lecture of science class 5. Today we will discuss unit number 2, which is material. This unit has its subunit matter, which is chapter number 3 of your syllabus. We all know that all the things are made up of the matter. The objective of our chapter is learn what are atoms and molecules, understand the arrangements of molecules in solid, liquid, gas, understand the state of changes of matter, gain knowledge about properties of substance. Students, now there is a warm-up exercise for you on your book page number 24. You have to color this diagram with a crayon. There is now your activity on your book page number 26. It is take the correct sentences and cross the wrong ones. You have to put the tick or cross in front of the statement. Now the topic is the change of state, means the solid state can be changed into the liquid state and the liquid state can be changed into the gas state. Vice versa, the gas state can also be changed into the liquid state and liquid state can also be changed into the solid state, but by the effect of heating and cooling. You can see in the diagram, the solid can be changed into the liquid and liquid into the gas by the effect of heating and cooling. I will give you the example of water. Water is the universal solvent. So we can find out the water in the solid state like ice, liquid as the water and gas as the water vapors. You can see them in the diagrams also. Solid state of the water means ice can be changed into the liquid state by the heating effect. Means when you give the heat to the solid ice, it will change into the liquid water. After cooling the water, the same water will change into the water vapors or the gas. Vice versa, students, the gas can be changed into the liquid by the effect of cooling. When you will decrease the temperature of a gas, the gas will change into the liquid. Similarly, when you will heat that liquid, the liquid will change into the solid. Now students, there is a now you know exercise or activity on your book page number 21. The activity is that tick the correct sentences and cross the wrong ones. You have to put the mark of tick and cross in front of the statements with the help of your notes sending at your WhatsApp number. Now there's a topic, and the topic is the change of state of matter. Change of state of matter is that the solid state of the matter can be changed into the liquid and the liquid state of the matter can be changed into the gas, but by the effect of heating and cooling. You can see this on the board as well as in your textbook. The solid, I will give you the example of solid, liquid and gas. We know that water is the universal solvent. So, I will give you the example of water. Water in the state of solid, for example, ice. And in state of liquid, water itself. And in state of gas, water vapors. So, solid means ice. The solid state of water can be changed into the liquid by the effect of heating. And similarly, the liquid, the water itself, can be changed into the gas state or the water vapor state. You can see over here by the effect of heating or when you will increase the temperature of the liquid. Similarly, the gas can be changed into the cooling or when you will decrease the temperature of the gas or the water, water vapor state of the water. And the liquid state can be changed into the solid state by the effect of cooling. cooling or wind will decrease the temperature. Now the topic is types of change. There are different types of the change: reversible change, irreversible change, physical change, and the chemical change. Reversible change, I tell you, the change which can be reversed or moved backwards to get back the original substance are called reversible changes. The change of state of water, for example, ice can be changed into the water, and the same water can be changed into the ice, is the reversible change. Means it can come back to its original state, are called as the reversible change. Irreversible change. Irreversible change is the change which cannot be reversed into the original substance, are called as the irreversible change. For example, burning of paper. When you will burn the paper, it will change into the ash. We cannot get it back as a paper. So, burning of paper is the irreversible change. Now, the next one is the physical change. Physical change, it belongs to the appearance or the external structure of something. So, physical change, in physical change, I have given you the example of the states of water, like the water can be changed into the ice and the ice can be changed into the water. So, the molecules of the ice and the molecules of the water are the same. It is only a physical change. Means a change in which the substance remains the same and no new substance is formed is called as the physical change. Now it's about the chemical change. The last one change is that in physical change, I have told you that there is no new thing is formed. Means the substance remains as the same, but in chemical change, the new thing is formed. Something happened, like burning of paper. I have given you the example. In irreversible change, the burning of the paper, we cannot get back the paper as itself. When we burn the paper, it changes into the ash, or it is called as the combustion process. The second one is the corrosion. Corrosion is the rusting of iron. When iron is exposed to the humid air, a red layer is formed, or the red powder like layer is formed on the iron. So this is the process of corrosion. I'll tell you again that when iron is exposed to humid air, it rusts and a red layer can be seen on it. This is called corrosion. Corrosion is a chemical change. Now next topic is the solubility in liquids. For example, solid can be dissolved in the liquid, gas can be dissolved in the liquid, and liquid can be dissolved in a liquid. How? I'll give you some examples. Solid and liquids. When the molecules of the solid find space between the space of the molecules of the liquid, it mixes with the solid, it mixes with the liquid. Such a solid is said to be soluble in that liquid. For example, we will take the example of like peas in the water molecule. Peas. When you will add the peas in the glass of water, you will find out that peas will get their own place in the water. And water will adjust the space for the peas. Liquids in liquids. When two liquids mix with each other and appear as one liquid, they are said to be miscible. Miscible liquids, I'll give you the example of milk. When we will add the milk in water, they mix with each other very well. And we cannot separate them easily. If they do not mix, they are said to be immiscible. Means the two liquids which cannot be separated easily are solid as the immiscible solids. Sorry, immiscible liquids. I'll give you the example. Take a glass of water. Add a tablespoon of oil to the water. Oil is also the liquid and water is also the liquid. Stir the mixture. You will observe that oil keeps floating on the top and does not mix with the water. Thus, water and oil are the immiscible liquids. Gases and liquids. Gases and liquids. For example, fish's breath in the water. They use the oxygen dissolved in the water. Aerated drinks contain carbon dioxide gas. In fact, a large volume of the gas is dissolved in these drinks under pressure. So, as soon as the bottle or can is opened, some of the gas come out in the form of bubbles. Now, there is the now you know activity. On your book page number 29, you have to write down their answers from the notes sending at your WhatsApp number. We discuss the properties of substances. The substances are solid, liquid, gas. These are the states of matter. Their different properties of the substance are the thermal conductivity, electrical conductivity, and magnetism. By the name of thermal conductivity, I'll explain you that the word therm means heat and conductivity means to ability to conduct something or to store something. Molecules of some substances can carry heat easily. I already told you that therm means heat. So, it's the ability of the substance to conduct or to store the heat. Metals like iron, copper, gold and silver are the good conductors of heat. Utensils made up of the aluminium, steel, brass, copper are used for cooking. When these utensils are placed on the gas stove, they become hot. Because the iron or the metal, these metals can conduct or store heat energy. After that, there is the electrical conductivity. By the name of electrical, you will get able to understand. We have to discuss about the electricity. Means ability to conduct or to store electricity. Means the material which can conduct electricity are called as the conductors. For example, aluminium and copper are the good conductors of electricity and they are used in making the wires. And the material which cannot conduct electricity are called as the insulators. For example, wood and rubber. Wood and rubber are the bad conductors of electricity. They are also known as the insulators. The third one is the magnetism. It's about the magnetic attraction. Means the material which are attracted by the magnet are called as the magnetic material. For example, iron, cobalt, nickel are strongly attracted by the magnets and they are called as the magnetic substances. Similarly, those substances which are not attracted by the magnet are called as the non-magnetic material. For example, wood, glass, plastic and rubber. Now students, it's about the exercise of your chapter number 3, matter. Part A of the exercise, you have to write down the answers on the book. After that, part B is the what is the difference between the followings. You have to write down their answers on your notebooks very neatly with proper method of getting the school system as you are using before. After that, part C, answer these questions in short. You have to write down their answers on the notebooks. Now it's time for your homework. You have to learn all the material. Material means the written work you are writing on your notebooks or on the textbook. You have to learn all the materials from the book plus notebook of chapter number 3. Also write down the names of the different types of materials used in a bicycle. There's a project work for you. Make a model for solid, liquid and gas. So students, follow the official page of Kaizen school system for getting updates. Take care of yourself. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.